how we can forgive ourselves and forgive others, especially those who have hurt us or abused us, people that even now we may hate from years in our past. The word forgive means to let go, to loosen. The Greek word used in the Bible, aphemi, simply means to send away and to forget it. How can we do that? How can we forget what was done to us, even though we may terribly disagree with the people and what they've done to us? How can we still love them? The answer, I think, is in understanding what and who we are. We're not our bodies. We're not our constant changing thinking. We're spirit in our essence. That's who we are. That's what the original teachings of the man Jesus, I think, were all about. The presence, the reign of God is in you, is you. To as many who has received that, to them God gives the very power to become the son, the daughter of God, connecting with that one spirit of God, because God is spirit and those who worship God must worship him in spirit and in truth. Think about it. Bodies are mortal. They come and they go. Feelings go up and down. Opinions change. But that scripture line says, but Jesus Christ is that which is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Just like God, just like Spirit, just like you and I are in our inner essence, that divine spark, that divinity of whom we truly are. I like to think of that as sort of being, you know, the Volkswagen of our existence. You know, remember that advertisement which has been on recently this summer? The little boy having a birthday party and trying to break that piñata? He couldn't break it. So the mother says, well, let's go in the house and we'll have some dessert. The father stays behind and tries to smash it with a big stick. He can't even break it. And then it spins around and it's a Volkswagen. Well, that's what the spirit may be seen like, that entity. Oh, the body can be beaten. It can be slandered against, can be killed. But that inner indestructible force is forever and ever, and we can party when we understand and live that. Now, granted, the church did not teach that in the fourth century on. It said only Jesus was the Son of God, and only the body would then be resurrected of ours one day to be with him. Oh, what a terrible shutdown of the creative, that prior thousands of years of pagan teaching to say that only, you know, certain ones get the spirit, and then we die, and then when we finally are resurrected, you know, the bodies are eternal. You know, that's so limited. It limits so many other people who don't follow that confession. It's so destructive. We say that people don't confess that, why, they burn in everlasting punishment forever and ever. What an awful doctrine, that it's only the blood of Jesus that gives people the right to have that spirit for a temporary time in their lives, and then hope that when the body is buried, that it will be raised again indestructible. That's not what the Bible truly teaches. That's not what the early church taught. It simply taught in all of its varieties that we are spirit. We awaken to it. And that is that which is eternal among us all. And it's with us. Believe that. Grow into that. And you will find peace. And when you find that peace, you will be able to forgive other people who don't think like you, don't even agree like you. People who persecute you. You will learn, as the Apostle Paul said, you don't have to return evil for evil. You can even bless those who persecute you. You can begin to live out that Sermon on the Mount, going the second mile with people, always forgiving, doing good to all. One of my favorite books, A Course of Miracles, teaches this principle the same way, that we can't have peace until we forgive ourselves and extend it to others as well. The fear of God, it teaches, is the sure result of seeing pardon as unmerited. No one who sees himself as guilty can avoid the fear of God. But he is saved from this dilemma if he looks upon, if he can forgive. The mind must think of its creator as it thinks of itself. If you can see that your brother or sister merits pardon, You have learned that forgiveness is your right as much as his, and you will be at peace, and you will feel at peace. One of the great examples of this today, I believe, is His Holiness the Dalai Lama, who has been taken and driven out of his country. He's an exile for all these years in India. Hundreds and thousands tried to get out. Many of them were killed. Hundreds of monasteries and teaching universities were destroyed. And yet he never says one adverse, critical word of the Chinese. He just believes it's a misunderstanding. Even one of his followers who got out after 20 years in prison, tortured by his Chinese captors, said the hardest part of that imprisonment was giving up his love for his captors. What a testimony. It's a blessing that the world can see and meet and hear such one who has been through such humiliation and persecution, seen such death of his loved ones, his family, but who still sees beyond, understanding that this world and our bodies are merely illusions, passing forms, but sees the spirit as eternal, of which we all are a part, and thus we find our peace, extend it to others as we have it ourselves. God bless you with this, and may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in that Christos, that Jesus within you, and be a blessing to all.